alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon. It's the Falcons in possession to begin. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10. Steps away this time. And his first look is incomplete. Austin Hooper, the tight end, was the intended target. Now bring up second down.
I've got enough pressure to affect the accuracy and the timing of a guy trying to throw the football. And on that play, they ended up pushing him to his left. Contact him as he's trying to throw the football. And that led to the incompletion.
Looking deep for Julio. That's caught inside the 20.
Check.
Sometimes athleticism beats you as well. He just took off and went. And that's almost like one of your turkey ball games, isn't it? Just go with that. I'll hurt you. And it worked really well for them.
The boy after, no gimme in the snow, but it's up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Pretty clean and simple there. Just two plays of a long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number two. Here's Boscher to kick it away. This will be taken very short. Yeah, nice return, sets it up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Jaguars getting set to go. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs.
First play of the drive there is incomplete.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They come after them, they snap back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field.
Coleman, offense.
So a decent game. It's also not on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about other people celebrating. The guys who just gave up that play.
Bortles gets one on second down.
Shut!
The Eagles run, it's intercepted. Picked up by Robert.
Shut!
And he takes this one back into the end zone. The Falcon defense has a touchdown.
That was an interception, but on the field, the guys are picking it up. They're not saying that. We're not going to use it, but it's Oski. But that means catch the ball and get it the other way.
That's your vernacular. I've never heard anybody say Oski.
Ask around. They'll tell you.
Here's Bryant for the extra point. Bryant's extra point up and good. And that'll make the score 14-0. They'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This will be taken short. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. The Jags offense now gets set and heads back onto the field. Already down two touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game. And typically, those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down two touchdowns early. Probably not very deep into their script. I think they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet. And try to get those offense on this drive.
At least 3 points get that zero off the board. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. Cornelius Bowles. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on third down.
Holding offense.
That hold coming from the left side of the line.
Hands got caught in the cookie jar on that one, and the flag came out. Penalty against him.
And this third down looking very tough after the holding penalty. Third and long. After the penalty, it's going off.
Shut!
And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some drags, some quick-hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
As he's taken it about the 14. A very good return there, giving it even 20 yards. And that'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. Final play of the half for Tampa. Jumping pressure on Jordan Larson. So we've come to halftime in what's already a two-touchdown game. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman.